लेट अस लुक एट एनालिटिकल सिंथेसिस ऑफ स्लाइडर क्रैंक एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ थ्री से वी हैव नाउ फोर एक्यूरेसी पॉइंट्स. एंड वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट फंक्शन जनरेशन. ओके नाउ इफ यू हैव फोर एक्यूरेसी पॉइंट्स देन इन योर इक्वेशन you should have four design parameters. Okay, then only you can accommodate four accuracy points. So our, you see, our equation was actually this one. Okay, that describes the slider crank mechanism analytically. This was the equation. Okay. Now, see, we'll have to make some changes in the equation so that instead of 3, like previously, you see, I got k1, k2 and k3, only 3 design parameters. So with 3 design parameters, you cannot do 4 accuracy point synthesis. Okay. So we'll have to introduce one more parameter in this equation. And there are two ways to do that at least. Okay, one way is, let us say, we are given 5-1, 5-2, 5-3 and 5-4. Okay, or theta-1, theta-2, theta-3, theta-4. Okay, theta and phi, those are angles of the input link, theta or phi. Okay, that is same. So don't get confused if I use different symbol here. So you are given these theta, and if you are also given s1, s2, s3 and s4, okay, then you see, based on this equation, if you put those, you will get actually four equations, and there are only three design parameters, so it will not work. Okay, so what we can do is, we can take S1 as a design parameter. Okay, so when the crank angle is theta 1, then corresponding to that slider location S1, we have taken that as a design parameter. We have not specified that. Okay, and then we have specified, or we have given in the problem, these distances S12, S13, S14. Okay, these are given. Okay, so S12 is when angle changes from theta 1 to theta 2, then displacement is S12. This is displacement in going from 1 to 2, displacement in going from 1 to 3. Okay, but S1 is not given. We will introduce in the equation S1 as a design parameter. Okay, so that we get four design parameters, and then we can accommodate four accuracy points. Okay, now based on this, you will write say S, let us see. Actually, first let me write this equation in a slightly different form. Okay, this equation, I'm writing that as (2a1) sj. Okay, so I have just introduced a subscript here, where j goes from 1 to 4, okay, for 4 accuracy points. Sj cos theta j plus 2a1a3 sin theta j minus 2a3 square is equal to as j square. Okay, so I have just introduced this subscript j. And now we can write Sj as S1 plus S1j. Okay, in this equation, Sj has to be substituted by S1 plus S1j. Okay, what that means is, you see, S1 will be equal to S1 plus S11. Okay, but S11 is 0, displacement in going from 1 to 1. Okay, and S2 will be S1 plus S12. Okay, so S2 will be S1 plus displacement in going from 1 to 2. Okay, that is naturally S2. Okay, but Sj, we will replace that with S1 plus S1j. Okay, so you have Sj here. And Sj here, we will replace that with this. And then we have introduced another parameter in this equation, S1. Okay, so let us do that quickly and see. So our equation becomes 2a1 Okay, this is the equation, and this equation can be rearranged, and this, after some rearrangement, this gives 2a1 Okay, this is what you get after some rearrangement. Okay, and now you see A1 we don't know, S1 also we want to take as a design parameter. So this combined, okay, we can call that as K1, that is a design parameter. Okay, similarly here 2A1, okay, let us call that a design parameter, K2. And Sij, this is given. Okay, I already told you in the problem, S11 is 0, but S12, S13, S14, this is given. This is given 2A1, A3. Let us call this as another design parameter, K3. And then this one is another, let us call this whole thing as K4. And this is given, but S1 is a design parameter. So let us call this whole thing as K5. Okay. So you can write this equation in form of K1, K2, K3, K4, K5. And here J goes from 1 to 4. Okay, so you will write 4 equations here. Okay, because based on what is given for 4 accuracy points, you are given theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, theta 4, S1, 2, S1, 3, S4. So you'll write J 4 equations for J 1 to 4. Now you have four equations, but it appears like there are five unknowns here, k1, k2, k3, k4, k5. So you have four equations, but five unknown. It appears like that. But if you examine it, you will see that 2k1 is actually equal to k2, k5. So they are not independent. 2k1 equals k2, k5. Okay, so they are not independent. This one has to be satisfied. And this is called this additional relation. This is called compatibility equation. But now you can say effectively you have five equations, four equations for this and one this compatibility equation, and you can solve those five equations to get k1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then the synthesis is done. Okay, but these equations here, they are not linear, so there are methods to solve that, but that is how you will do this synthesis. Okay, let me also show you this in Dannewitt-Hartenberg book. This is described in section 10.6, not in 10.6, actually 10.7. Okay, if you see section 10.7, it says synthesis of the slider crank mechanism with four accuracy points. And here it discusses those things. Okay, introduction of another design parameter, and then this compatibility equation, and then it also describes how you can solve these nonlinear equations. Of course, we can just do using computer, but here it describes a method for solving. So if you like, you can go through that. That's all.